I'm really glad to be standing in this panel among such prominent members of our society. And as the student speaker of our panel, I decided to look at the youth, at my friends, and at my social network, and ask them what they wanted out of the city and what troubles they were facing. And I did manage to find a lot of problems. Various things which have already been discussed, like transportation. One of the biggest concerns was the power cuts. People are very uncomfortable with the power cuts. Et cetera, et cetera. They had a lot of complaints which have been dealt with by the other speakers. So I thought I would, since I am not of a level of expertise and experience as the other speakers on our panel, I thought I would discuss something that we could do on a small scale. And one of the most common complaints, one of the most common features, was that people are very unhappy about the way the roads are, the way we're living, the environment. Basically, they want a cleaner and greener city. So I thought about it, and well, we all complain, and the easiest thing to do, which we all first thing we do, is we blame the authorities. And yes, you know, we all of us do that, but you know, how much can we blame, how much can they do if the citizens aren't willing to cooperate? And then the next thing that we do is we blame the rest of the community. But you know, it's time that we start looking at what we're doing. And I think the change in the way we live, and you know, to stop people from throwing garbage on the streets, and to just treat the city with more respect, treat the pedestrians, treat everyone with more. My parents always tell me to respect what's around me, not just myself, but I need to respect all life forms, everything around me, I need to give it concern. So that could be applied with bettering our city. And yeah, so you know, over there you're thinking like, okay, what's the solution? How are we gonna get there? So what we do is we criticize and then we advise. You know, people told me, okay, why don't you go up there and tell them, okay, next time you're on the streets and you know, you feel like littering, don't do it. Follow the rules. And I could sit here and tell you, but I'm pretty sure that every one of you in this room knows that. Okay, it's not something new. It's not like you guys don't know what you're supposed to do, but you know, our society, our community is so vast, and we have masses of people. And it's quite, you know, it doesn't make sense to keep advising, because efforts aren't always equal to results. You know, we need to start, if what we're doing isn't producing results, we need to see what are we doing wrong, and is there another way I could change it? So I was thinking, and something that my uncle Donald, who's sitting here in the audience, told me, which you know was which really inspired me, was that the fact that he's traveled all over the world, and he's a wonderful person, and he's seen so much, and what he told me was that the way we as human beings perceive life is through comparison. Anything we do, we always compare ourselves, we always benchmark ourselves based on what we see, what's better or what we're used to. So for example, if you're in a car, you're driving in a car at 100 kilometers per hour, you feel like you're going very, very fast. That is until another car comes past you at 150, and then you're like, it's so slow, and you just realize how slow you are when you see something much better. And at the same time, if you go really fast and then you know you slow down, then you realize where you're standing, and you realize how you can go somewhere better. And the fact is that when we need to change our society, the first thing, you know, yes, there's a macro level of creating a better infrastructure and you know, creating better roadways and transport and all of that, but the root cause is a society, and it's the mentality of the society. But the bad news here is that the slowest thing to change is not infrastructure or transportation or even corruption. Like a person asked a question, how long is it going to take for the corruption to change? but it's mentality of the people, and mentality takes generations. It's going to change after generations. And so maybe we can't affect mentality by telling people what to do. How about we show them an example? By setting an example, not just setting an example, what I felt is that we need to step into the lives of the masses here. And that's not, you know, that's not the well-off. I'm not talking about the well-off, and I'm not talking about either extreme, the well-off or the slums. Because the people in the slums are barely trying to survive. That's like their main issue. But you have the middle class, and you have the masses of people coming up in the society who haven't seen anything better. So, you know, perhaps they're coming from the villages and they're coming to the cities to see what more life could give them, but they're not that exposed. So I say that we need to step into their lives and show them what could be better, so that when they see what's better, immediately all of them want to change, and their mentality is changed so that they want to see a better life and they start working towards it, instead of just listening to your advice about moral concerns. So this brings me to my idea, which I thought I would share with you. And I thought that we could get the support of the youth, and I want volunteers and we want sponsors. So what we can do is we could go into the city and pick one street, okay? And I'd like to consult people to see what kind of street, like where they would like to target, where there are a lot of people, a lot of consumers, a lot of residents, and see what they would like to change. And we go into that one city because we can't change the entire city. So we go into that one street, and we go there and we transform it completely, because this change is going to be gradual, you know? So let's just focus on one small area of the city first. And we go there. And then, you know, hopefully, I'm sure we have the resources and we have people who are willing to help us. So we just need more supporters. I need, you know, information from experts. I need the guidance of experts. We need people to, like, just come and support the cause. We could take a street and transform it completely. And hopefully, when we show them what, you know, how life could be on that street, you know, everyone stepping into that street would want that too. And, you know, and slowly that could become viral, you know, and everyone starts getting it, everyone starts talking about it, it becomes bigger than Kolaveri. And then you have all these people, you're talking about it every day, and everyone's going, I want more, I want a bigger city, I want more out of life, I want a better living standard. You have cities realizing what potential they can achieve. And this is not just the educated people, this is not just us, it's not just people who are well off and have traveled abroad, but it comes viral that all of us start looking at it, and even the lower section of the society knows what it's like, and then they start cooperating, and then they start picking up their garbage. They start realizing that they can't urinate on the streets because everyone else is against it now. And maybe if we just take a small part of the city and show them what it's like, and maybe just, you know, talk to those people and convince them personally, not just advise like this, but, you know, ask them to cooperate, maybe we could start a change in the entire city, and I really hope that happens. And thank you.